Pat. Pat.
Hey, I'm in here.
There you are, Pat.
What are we up to today?
Hey, Cass, I'm glad you came to the lab. Today, we are going to figure the bulk-specific gravity of a compacted asphalt specimen.
Is this like bodybuilder bulking? Are we going to give the asphalt a protein shake or
something? No. We are going to use this compacted asphalt specimen to determine the bulk-specific gravity, which we can then use to calculate the density and onto the air voids. So we're going to calculate the bulk specific gravity of this asphalt specimen that we can then use to calculate the density and onto the air voids. And we do it for many reasons. So two important pay factors for agencies are the laboratory air voids or the in-place density that we use this test for. We also, anytime we're going to do performance testing, we use this test as well.
Okay, well, I know we talked about performance testing a lot, and I know you've said a lot about air voids and density and specific gravity and bulk something, but I'm not sure what you're talking about. Are you pranking me?
No, Cass, no. There's lots of different terms that it all kind of talks about the same process. So the ASHTO T166 is the bulk specific gravity of a compacted asphalt mixture using the saturated surface dry method. We figure the bulk specific gravity, then calculate the density, then calculate the air voids.
So this is like the first step.
Exactly. So next I want to talk about this sample that we're going to use here, right? So this particular one is a laboratory compacted asphalt mixture. Some places call it a pill or a plug, a briquette. Other places call it a puck.
He shoots, he scores.
I guess. So let's talk about the setup we have here. So the first thing we need is a balance that's capable of measuring 5,000 grams and reads to the nearest tenth of a gram. Next, we need a cable that runs down to a basket or a holder inside the water bath. We need a timer, a thermometer, and a damp towel.
It's quite the setup.
Yeah, well, all asphalt laboratories are going to have a setup that's similar to this with different size tanks, different shapes of tanks, but some are gonna be built into racks, others into cabinets. This one works really well for us because it's mobile and it's easy to clean.
So then what are the keys to watch for in different setups?
Well, that's a great question. First off, we want to make sure our balance is in good working order, that it's stable, that it's level. Next, we want to make sure that this cable is not touching the sides as it runs down through here into the water bath.
Yeah, okay, I see that.
The next one is we want to make sure that our water bath temperature is within the specified range, which is 25 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree.
All right, well, now what?
So now, let's go ahead and take the mass of our sample that's in the air. This is going to be a dry, cool sample.
Looks like the mass is 4,945.1 grams.
You've got it. Now we're going to put it in the water.
Oh, but didn't we just make sure it was dry?
Well, yeah, we did. But now we are going to measure the mass suspended in water and use that to calculate the bulk specific gravity.
Okay. Oh, hold your breath, little buddy. Well, it looks like the mass is...
Whoa, hold on. We need to let everything equalize. So the specification says that it needs to be in the water bath for 4 minutes, plus or minus 1 minute before we take the reading. So here's the timer.
All right, time's up. The mass is 2,839.7 grams.
Yep, you've got it. So next, we are going to pull it out of the water bath and dry it a specific way with this damp towel here to get it to the saturated surface dry condition.
SSD?
Yeah, you've caught it.
Wow, Josh Gordon, that was quick.
Well, the specification says that the drying process should take no more than 15 seconds. So the new mass is 4,950.3 grams.
Got it.
So now that we have the SSD mass, I want to talk about what SSD actually is. So we dry our sample with the damp towel in a specific way so that we remove all the water from the surface of the specimen, but we leave the water that's in the little voids that are inside there.
Okay, so now that we have the masses, do we move on to calculation?
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. So we're going to calculate the GMB by dividing the dry mass by the difference between the SSD mass and the underwater mass.
So I'm going to take 4,945.1 grams over 4,950.3 grams minus 2,839.7 grams. And then that equals 2.3433.
Yeah, that's right. And I'm so glad you took that to three decimal points, because whenever we're talking about specific gravities, we always use three digits after the decimal point.
Well,